My name is Sarita Govindan, and I've been learning Tai Chi now for a year from Chittipon. So I was at a Kung Fu performance where I was performing at the school that I belonged to at that point. And so we just finished our performance, and after that, Shifu Peng, he came in and he started his form, and I was watching from back of the stage, and I found it amazing. You know, the smoothness and the grace, and yet the power. I thought, this is outstanding. I must learn it. You know? So later on, I asked my Shifu, what was this? What is this person? And he said, it's Sao Bao Tai Chi. And so somehow mentally, it sort of stayed in my mind. And the Kung Fu Shifu had a seminar on Sao Bao Tai Chi for beginners like us. Like, so I attended it, I heard what they had to say, and I said, yes, this is something I must learn. I have to learn. Yes, I did. Because when Shifu Peng does it, it seems so easy, like effortless, and you think, oh, this is easy peasy, I can do it. But then, you know, to sort of bring about that level of effortlessness and grace is not as easy as we think. It took me some time to sort of coordinate my breath and move. It was a little easier because I've done Kung Fu, but still, at the same time, there was a bit of a challenge. Relaxing the body is more difficult than learning the form. Form, eventually, Shifu Peng breaks it down. It's such easy, like 1, 2, 3, 4, he sort of breaks down the movement. So eventually, I will get that, I have no, you know, doubt about. But the ability to relax and to be grounded, so like from, I think from Dantian down to be like super solid and get like super graceful, you know, Dantian up. That is a challenge. My understanding is after studying the forms and practicing it, I found that the Zhuangzhuang, that is sort of typical in many ways. So let's say I practice maybe 4 to 5 times a week. I'll do like 3 rounds of 24 forms. But somehow what calls to me is the Zhuangzhuang. So then I will go through an entire set of holding the sequence for 2-3 minutes each. I feel that grounds me because I have a very sort of anxious and hyperactive mind. And in the process of standing still, I feel that helps me a lot. Standing meditation. Because while sitting, it is much more easy for the mind to sort of run amok. But in standing, there is effort, right? In the standing sitting. Mind sort of goes back to the body and it stays with the body. So it's not sort of running in, you know, 1,000 different directions as much.